My name is Quintar Genga, MSc, Soil Fertility Specialist, working for International Fertilizer Development Center, based in Nairobi, Kenya. What inspired me to join science? So growing up, I've been an inquisitive type of child. I've always been fascinated on knowing how things work, why they work the way they do. And that led me to gaining interest in the technical subjects. And that's how I came to start my science career.
I am Dr. Ngunjiri. I work as an agronomist and GIS specialist at the International Fertilizer Development Center, and I'm based in Nairobi, Kenya. So having been born and raised in a rural background, my family could barely put food on the table. And the best revenge that I could have was to join the science community, because from school, I was aware that scientists and researchers could perform some magic to fight poverty and enhance food security.
In my formative years, I didn't notice any challenges, mostly because I was surrounded with people who encouraged me to do science. I was in a all-girls high school, where every single day they kept telling us on how women can conquer the world, women can do anything, women are just as smart as men. And I think hearing that over a long period of time, you start to believe it. And you get self-confidence, and that's how I managed to go to the university and do science-related courses.
Most of my challenges emanated from living and being brought up in an uncivilized community where women were viewed as belonging to the house and not the office. I knew education was the only way out for me. I had seen so many women scientists and researchers scale to high levels in education, and they had good lives. Besides that, I also had a lot of support from family and friends, where I got mentorship, and I made sure that I upheld these values.
In the professional setup, women are given less challenging roles, and to many it might seem like a positive, but this is actually a negative, because it gives the implication that women cannot handle more challenging roles. Then now we have these women who also make it to the top. We expect them that now that they're in a leadership position, they'll be able to advocate for more women in the middle level. But you find that when they get to that level, they kind of pull away from other women and they relate more to the men. And this now reinforces the gender bias.
Some policies create the impression that including women at work means having equal opportunities between both men and women, and they fail to continue to work to overcome the fundamental issue of gender bias.
We've had many female authors, but when you go through research and articles in these big journals and the recognized journals, we find that it's mostly male authors who are cited, and this dampens female researcher spirits, because you'll do the same work as a man, you'll have the same output, but when it comes to your research being cited in publications, in conferences, it's harder for women authors to get recognition as compared to the male counterparts.
Some statistics have shown that women own less than 13% of agricultural land, which means that men own more than 85% of agricultural land, and this is due to discriminatory laws and practices.
In developing countries, we find that women are the center of food production. Women grow most of the food that is consumed in the household. They contribute to most of the labor.
If women had access to land, livestock, education, financial services, technology, and even rural employment, it could see an increase in agricultural productivity, which would mean enhancement in food security, economic growth, and social welfare.
Having more women in research, especially in agricultural research, will trigger changes that will positively affect food production geared towards women.
Some statistics have shown that for every 77 cents of a dollar earned by a man earns a dollar. And the wage gap is even larger for expectant mothers, immigrant women, and even women of color. More so, expectant women and mothers are forced into the so-called motherhood penalty, where they get involved in informal, casual and part-time jobs where actually they are very much overrepresented and are paid less.
Having women in science is really important. First and foremost, this will create role models to younger girls, to junior scientists, to anyone just venturing into the science world. This will show them that women can take up science-related subjects in school for their career. This will eliminate the misconception that women are less competent scientists as compared to men. Also, having more women in leadership will positively affect gender policies, which may reduce gender discrimination and bias.
There's no specific blueprint to this, but conscious and unconscious bias can be eliminated through support by both men and women. We are not trying to raise the female gender over the male gender, but we are trying to eliminate bias of male over female in science.